Welcome to ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil, your software solution for the inspection of tactile, optical 3D, and volume data of blades, vanes, and airfoils in general. In this video, we'll have a look at the user interface. Let's dive right in and open the ZEISS Quality Suite, your platform for metrology software, services, news, and updates. When you start it, you'll get a little tour, so feel free to take a look. If you want to try ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil, take a look at the description below. There, you'll find links to download the software, request a free trial, and download training data. Please log in. Or register for a ZEISS ID if you don't have one yet. Under All Applications, you can see and install all available applications. Once you installed them, you can either click on an application and start it from here, or go to My Applications to open them. And for even faster access, you can add applications to the menu bar and launch them directly. ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil opens with the Start screen. Here, you can create a new project, open an existing project, or a recently used project. You always need a project to work with the software. Through the Start screen, you can also access the ZEISS Quality Tech Guide and Training Center. Here, you'll find more information and trainings for your software and hardware products. But back to the Start screen. If you want to play around with the software but have no data available, you can download sample data. The software redirects you to the ZEISS Quality Suite, where you can download free example projects. I'll open a recently used project to explain the user interface. Let's start with the 3D view, which is right in the center. The 3D view is your main work area. It's where the data is displayed. You can turn the object with the left mouse button, zoom in and out with the mouse wheel, and pan the object by pressing the mouse wheel. To rotate the object to the left or right, press Shift and the left mouse button. You can also click the cube in the left corner to display a standard or isometric view. Now let's move on to Workspaces, which you find in the side panel on the left. Workspaces are dedicated to assignments such as airfoil CMM data preparation, airfoil inspection, inspection, reporting, and mesh editing. Start brings you back to the Start screen. Now you might wonder why there are two inspection workspaces, airfoil inspection and inspection. Here's why. When you switch between workspaces, the main toolbar changes to provide the tools you need for the tasks in the specific workspace. It's designed to guide you through the main steps in each workspace. The inspection workspace is used to inspect subcomponents such as roots, disks, hubs, and shrouds. If you want more information about this workspace, please have a look at the starter guide ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D or the Inspect Airfoil Optical 3D Data Basic e-learning. If you're working with tactile data, you'll use the Airfoil CMM data preparation workspace before continuing on to inspect the data. For more information, check out the Inspect Airfoil CMM Data Basic e-learning. In this starter guide, we'll cover some of the most important functions of the airfoil inspection workspace, which, you guessed it, is designed to support your airfoil inspections. Now, in the airfoil inspection workspace, the main toolbar provides the workflow support. The workflow support guides you through each step of the airfoil profile and 3D inspections, from creating a stacking axis, profile sections, and inspections to reporting your results. Functions are easy to find and structured according to our recommendations for your convenience. For example, when creating a stacking axis, we recommend the use of local coordinate systems when possible. That's why the options to create local coordinate systems are on the top of the list. Please note that some of the functions here are only relevant for optical 3D data. To find out more, take a look at the video How to Perform Airfoil Profile Inspections in ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil. Through the main toolbar, you can access iInspect, a pie menu that manages inspection functions and helps guide you through the inspection process. The functions that are available in iInspect depend on the selected element, but more about that later. We'll be using it extensively in the following tutorials. What I want to show you for now is that iInspect has a dedicated menu for airfoil profile inspections. Next to the workspace side panel is the Explorer. The Explorer contains a tree of all elements in your project, whether they have been imported or created during your inspection. The elements are divided into different categories, such as part, which can have a name, like in this case, and report pages, for example. The category part is essential and contains all the elements for the analysis of a part. That means nominal and actual data, as well as inspection elements, and so on. Everything is well organized and easy to find. If you want to display elements in the 3D view, just drag and drop them into the 3D view with the left mouse button. When you do that, the elements will be displayed exclusively. You can also select them in the Explorer and use the keyboard shortcut E. If you want to display an element in addition to the content in the 3D view, toggle the visibility here or use the keyboard shortcut V. Now, before we continue, let's talk about customizing the user interface. In ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil, you can display the information you need exactly where you want it. All you need to do is drag and drop the different windows into the respective docking areas on the left, the right, or the top. And the software even supports multiple monitors. To add a window, click the plus. To reset the layout to the default, click View, Screen Setup, Reset All Workspaces. Underneath the main toolbar, you'll find the status bar. The colors provide information about your project and let you know if there's anything you need to address. For more details, look at the project guide. Here, you'll find a comprehensive list of all hints and warnings divided into different categories. This list is designed to guide you through the troubleshooting process and suggests possible actions. To evaluate your part in ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil, you need an alignment. When you're working with CMM data, the alignment is usually part of the imported data. However, when you're working with optical 3D data, you need to create the alignments in ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil. A project can contain several alignments, and you can switch between them at any time. When you switch to another alignment, the software automatically recalculates all the elements because an alignment change affects the inspections in the project. You can also create a new alignment at any point in time. Now, if you want to view or change the properties of an element in your project, open the Properties window on the right. You can also use the Tab key to open it. The content of the Properties window depends on the element you selected in the Explorer or the 3D view. For the mesh, for example, you can display the mesh structure or adjust the transparency. Next, we'll look at the toolbar. It contains various selection commands. To find more selection commands, open Edit Selection in 3D. You can add these selection commands and any other function to the toolbar by using drag and drop. You can also reorganize the tools in the toolbar and delete them. Alternatively, you can access the most important selection commands by clicking the right mouse button on the background in the 3D view. If you're looking for a software function or more information, use the search function here. But please note that the search function is optimized to find functions from the Construct menu, not functions that are part of the main toolbar or the Airfoil Inspection menu in iInspect. The results are divided into Functions and Help. When you click on a function, the Function dialog opens and you can proceed to use the function. If you click on an entry under Help, the ZEISS Quality Tech Guide opens in the ZEISS Quality Suite. You can also open the Tech Guide from any dialog window by clicking the question mark. In the tech guide, you'll find information about workflows, software functionalities, and parameters. That's it for this short introduction to the user interface. To start working with the software, take a look at the video, How to Import Data with ZEISS Inspect Airfoil. And if you're looking for a more comprehensive training, check out the Inspect Airfoil Optical 3D Data Basic e-Learning or the Inspect Airfoil CMM Data Basic e-Learning if you're working with tactile data. You'll find the link in the description below.